So we're going to look at an example of a relation or a table that we just talked about. This example that we have here is the name of this relation or table is employee because it stores information about employees that we have maybe in a certain company. So the columns or the attributes schema that we're talking about is defined as follows. You're going to have an employee name, going to have an identifier for the department in which they work. That's a DID. The salary, we don't have the value, but we have a code for the salary. We have the employee's ID, and then we have their phone. The information about a given employee consists of their name, their department, the salary code, their ID, and their phone number, so you can reach them. Now, in this particular organization, we have a bunch of employees, Robin, Neil, Jasmine, Cody, Ollie, and so on. So for each of them, we're going to have a tuple. So if you look at sort of a given row in this table here, that is what we are calling a tuple. And we uniquely identify those by the employee ID. So in case of Robin, for example, 2345 is the primary key value for employee Robin. So we're going to see primary keys are how we actually say what set of employees we may want to get information about and things like that. So this is the key, and these are the key values that we have here. So as you can see, for each employee, that information makes up a tuple in the table. The collection of those is structured, organized this way, that's what makes a table. The various attributes that we have, which define what's stored in this table, is based on this schema that we have here. I have something else here which said foreign key, and the reason I included that here is because sometimes you may want to do operations across different tables. So foreign key basically is going to be a key in some other table, and we can do what is called joins, for example. If you want to put data together from multiple tables, well, you can say this is the foreign key that should match a primary key in another table, and then I want to pull information about Robin's department, salary code, and employee ID from here, and her social security address, other things from a different table, and things like that. So there, maybe the department ID is the key, for example, and it won't be unique in if you're trying to pull social security numbers and things like that. So foreign key is essentially a primary key somewhere else, and somehow sometimes you may have to sort of combine information from multiple tables, and we use these keys for doing that. And so some of the fields may be the attribute values that we have here. You're not going to use them as a key for accessing tuples from here, but when you refer to another relation and operation across multiple tables, that's where they get used. Again, if you've done your database course, you probably have learned a lot more about it than what we need here.